Welcome back to Let's Play the Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch, Legend of Heroes. I am Amethyst Lunatari. We're here with Joanna, who's just joined us. And we're supposed to be going to get her grandfather out of jail in Dorufes over here. We found her and Arosa right here. So suffice it to say, we're heading south and then east. Dorufes 840 Milos. South is a Dilt checkpoint. No reason to go there. And north is Arosa, where we just came from. We'll fight some monsters with her. I really had her pegged as a spellcaster. Oh, cool. Anger. Minimal effect. Oh well. Now last time these poison beetles ran up to the front, so let's go after them. Oh. Oh nice, one-shot it. Sweet! How much damage did you do? It ran off the screen. Here, she says. Death to the shoddy squid. Well, she hits pretty hard with that spear. The Spear of Destiny. Chris levels up to 31. What's the name of it? Hold on a second. Okay. Spear of Winds. Alright, we'll fight you as well. I want to get some XP and check out her finishing move. I love one-shotting these things. Missed. How dare you miss? Oh, we gotta heal up soon. Some of us. She did 420 damage. Got a cure potion. We have 8 of them. But we don't need to use those. Let us use our magic. What is the most magic right now? Oh, we are full. Alright. Well, Chris technically has more. No, Stella has more. Let's have Stella help out with healing. Probably should have used Recure. Hi. Okay, here we go. Finishing move. Brave Rush. Right here in the middle. We'll focus the rest of us on this thing. We did hit that one at the end. Oh my god, nice. Awesome. That was easy. Hi. Joanna's finishing move. Shine flat, whatever that. I'll do shoddy squid A. Ran past the area. Something spell your doom. Oh, it's one of those. Wow, 710 damage. Hey! Take this. Out of these, did we hit the poison beetle yet? Let's go after the poison beetle. There we go. Chris is hurt. Stamina food and another cure potion. That's good, because we were using those up when we had no healer in the party. Now we're getting them all back. We can get one more before we're topped off of those. Okay, so... Chris now. Recure. It just bumps us out when there's nowhere to heal, nobody to heal. We'll fight you. We have some finishing moves to use up. Sacred Fall, all enemies. Alright, check out Sacred Fall. Evil be purged by Sacred Light, yeah, that's what she says. Pretty cool. But the enemy remains, at least three of them. Missed. Will not be poisoned by the likes of you. Chris, level 32. And Yurio? Not yet. We got seafood and another stimulant. Good, because we used one a couple episodes ago. Yurio says, how long before we get to Dorufes? The monster answers, you're almost there. Keep going. It's not that far, Joanna says. The town is just a short distance away. Chris asks, is the Tower of Dorufes located near the town? Yes, it's on the south side of the town. The town began as an imperial villa of Castle Rudo. Many soldiers are stationed there, but it seems like the town is peaceful. I hope I'll be able to see my grandfather soon. Stella says, I don't know about that. I think we better gather some information in the town. Yurio says, I wonder what kind of person Master Durzel is. He is very famous, says Chris. Well, you could ask his granddaughter. I'm getting nervous, says Chris. Yurio. Joanna chuckles. He may not talk much, but he is a kind person. I respect my grandfather, too. On that note... Stella, finishing move, magic burst. I'm only gonna hit, oh, two of them. Not bad. I didn't kill any of them. I am disappointed. Were we attacking B already? Probably. Oh, you missed. Oh boy, you have poison now. I got rid of one, finally. Oh, crap. Okay. Well, Nurio. Can she revive her? No. Alright. So Stella will use the stimulant on Chris. And then Chris, once revived, will heal Yurio's poison. Well, cure his poison, rather. Oh crap, she's out again. Shoddy Squid A. Actually, B? Stella. Revive her again. By the time we're able to cure his poison, the battle's gonna be over. I got one left. You might as well just finish. Yurio levels up, and his poison only lasts for the combat, so... So he is now level 33. Yeah, he doesn't have the status on him. Okay, so Chris has more magic points. You're afraid of us now? What about one more battle? Actually, that might not be the town over there. That might be more road. Rave Rush! Wait, no, no, no. This one. Wow. Good, I was hoping she didn't get to use that, because it would be a waste at this point. That thing's already damaged. Ah, he missed. Stella? Well, she stopped moving. She's too far ahead of the other two. Yeah, there's more road here. I heard that. Hello. You're a shaggy looking thing. Pick penguin and shoddy squid. Guess the pink penguin might be the new deadly enemy. I don't think of penguins as being deadly, though. Joanna will do a finishing move on this big penguin. Watch my spear, spell your doom. Nice, 750 points. Is that the most damage we've done so far? She didn't get to go. They're all missing, though. Oh, okay. Well, they were. It was B, I think we were attacking? The pig penguin. B. Oh, we killed B. Okay, maybe it was A. Then there was one. Okay, Stella. Nope, she stopped again. The game wants us to catch up with her. Alright, going south again. Dorufes! Came from Arosa and Tilt Checkpoint. Those are both north. Shall we fight something else? Oh, we found something. Too late. Nice. I like that. I encourage that kind of behavior. Alright, this thing's damaged. Ouch. More seafood. Say, are you hungry yet? Hungry! Let's do the earth one. What's that? Earth organic. Okay, and Chris. Recure. Must I? There's some rocks. Boom. Doesn't do much damage nowadays, but yeah. Finishing move. Brave Rush. Chris, all enemies. Stella will just attack. Joanna will just attack. Bit of a waste. Actually, a lot of a waste, because that's a multi-enemy thing and we only hit one. Come on, Stella! Ah, she stopped again. One more will do it. I want to get her up to the next level. Unless we got another finishing move to use. Magic Burst. I guess right in the middle. Nice. Wow. Kill that thing. I think it automatically Okay, maybe not. I thought it was like just defaulting to the one that's most damage. It didn't do it for everyone. Come on, Stella, there you go. Stella, level 35. Barely. Alright, let's get to the Dorufes. You know, we've cleared out all these things. Alright, we need to get information. Much is going on at the castle, but it's quiet here in Dorufes. That's because I'm watching out for the town. Nothing is better than peace and quiet. I think about it a lot lately. You think about peace and quiet a lot. Mm-hmm. How do we get in here? O'Neill says, soldiers are so honest and disciplined, they make me swoon. I love soldiers in armor. Oh boy. Reperuto says, the soldiers change in the barracks before and after their shifts. I feel so light every time I take off my armor. I feel like going to a bar for a drink. It's very peaceful here. There's no reason for the garrison to stay manned. We guard this place only because it's King Rudolph's villa. Okay. Oh. Oh, this one. Well, now it's my turn to stand guard. I put on my uniform and wash my face. I'm ready. Did you brush your teeth too? Why don't I wait here for a while until the current shift ends? Why don't you? Why don't you, I say? Why don't you? Oh, her again. How do I get in this one? I'll talk to the little girl in a second. Reno says, it was long ago when Dorufes was built as an imperial villa of Castle Rudo. This town is also important to Castle Rudo for a different reason. This is where King Rudolph and Queen Isabel met for the first time. As a woman, I'm more interested in that part of the story. Stereotypical, much? As a woman. Sephair says, Dorufes was built as an imperial villa of Castle Rudo. The coastline made it a perfect resort villa. But the king hasn't visited here for 20 years. The soldiers say even the Tower of Dorufes, which was built for the queen, is now used as a prison. Alright, do you sell stuff? Because you're at a table. I guess not. Oh. Hello. Raisin? Wow, that's unexpected. What, your name being Raisin? We have travelers. We can't serve alcohol to kids, but please make yourself at home. Our customers are all off-duty soldiers. They're good-natured fellows. Don't worry, they won't give you any trouble. Sure, let's get some rest here. Yeah. That's enough resting, you slackers. Supati says, those guys guarding the tower are probably having a tougher time than we are. They let monsters run free in the tower as watchdogs. Let monsters run free? Says Chris. Chris says, yeah, imagine monsters running around you. That's scary. But you're safe as long as you don't enter the tower. Huh, really? What did you say? It let them run free in the tower as watchdogs. Oh boy. I wonder, we're probably gonna end up having to fight those things then. Peril says, Our job is to guard the area between the town of Dorufes and a tower. It seems a lot of things are going on back at the castle, but everyone is relaxed here. It's almost boring. Almost, I tell you, almost. Hello? Alice says, it's not fun to play hide-and-seek alone. I hope the soldiers will play with me again soon. Okay, then. Hi. Nothing is better than peace and quiet. Oh. Alright, so we've explored everything on this side. You, what do you have to say? Hoker? Says women love soldiers and swordsmen for some reason. I envy those guys a bit. Perhaps I should go to Castle Voodoo and sign up for the army myself. Yeah, then you'll just die in battle, like a fool. Instead of meeting women. Chica? Says, did you know they've increased taxes and ordered a military draft recently? Things are not too bad in Dorufes, because the town developed as an imperial villa of Castle Rudo, and control has been tight. But in small villages, I hear some people are leaving Fothia for other countries. Bolfi says, only ladies who like soldiers brag about the town's prosperous past as an imperial villa of Castle Rudo. Whether or not the town has something to do with the castle has no impact on our life. Well, everyone's talking about it. Including the ladies standing right there near you. Okay, we got exclamation marks. Gonna talk to them last. Because I want to see what else is going on. Domino the Chapel Master. Yeah, we don't need this stuff. It's the same stuff. Alright. I will not come again. Delpo says, a talented sorceress visited this town some 20 years ago. Wouldn't be the Moonlight Witch, would it? What was her name? Oh yes, I remember. Her name was Gweld. There's your answer. Some people called her the Moonlight Witch. I wonder what happened to her. Chris says, the Moonlight Witch was here too? So you also know about her? The Moonlight Witch came here with Master Durzel. You know Master Durzel, the Castle Rudo court swordsman? I don't know what happened, but Master Durzel ended up a prisoner in the Tower of Dorufes. I have no idea what happened to the Moonlight Witch. I heard Master Durzel is keeping his mouth shut about her. Well, hopefully he'll spill the beans if we get him out of that prison. Which we're gonna have to fight monsters. Oh, you sell pet food? Yep. I never have to buy pet food, I just find plenty of it. I think I've bought pet food since, like, the very beginning. Oh, I didn't talk to them. I talked to you, right? Yeah. Oh. They say the queen is very beautiful. I wish I could see her just once. Alright, she's talking about Isabel. We didn't talk to her before. Sorry, guys. Ah. I missed the special item. Melinda says, hi there, what can I get you? Resist ring, plus three. Magic ring, plus three. Power ring. You know, just in case, I'm gonna buy a few elixirs. You're most welcome. Lloyd, the arms dealer, says, "Welcome. We're selling weapons to the garrison at Dorufes. We have a variety of excellent choices." Alright, Sword of Winds. Huh. Brings Yurio's speed down. Oops, sorry guys. A blue pearl rod for Chris, which is not an improvement, or Stella, never mind. Spear of Winds. Joanna already has it. Large shield. Yurio is something better. Robust shield is what Yurio has, apparently. Full plate. Yeah, this is like substandard stuff here. Could give it to Joanna, but it brings down two of her stats. Wisdom robes. Eh. I don't like the way it's bringing down avoidance. I mean, it might be worth it, but I'm just gonna skip it. As for Yurio... Wait, what's his... His speed is 57. If we get him this, Sword of Winds... Yeah, his speed goes down by 20. His attack goes up by 10. I'm gonna skip all this stuff, believe it or not. We talked to them. I think we've talked to everybody. These people again. I forget where they were. It's not them. Ah, it's you. Bieta says, "Alice is just a kid, so I'm not worried. But when she's grown up, I don't want her to fall in love with a soldier. Soldiers are only here temporarily. Once their mission is over, they'll go back to their hometowns. I think I worry too much." Yeah, she's a kid. I don't think you need to worry yet. Not for another eight years or something. Jinif says, "My daughter Alice loves hide-and-seek. Sometimes she plays with the soldiers when they're off-duty. The soldiers here are kind to children. They're helping me a lot by being such good babysitters." Alright, since these are important people, I think we need to go find the kid. Maybe? Did we talk this one? Oh. "This is the way to the Tower of Dorufes. It used to be an imperial villa of Castle Rudo, but now it's used as a prison to lock up criminals. I'm sorry, but I can't let ordinary citizens enter." Chris says, "Really?" Yurio says, "If we can't pass, we can't go to the tower." Chris says, "If we mention Joanna, he may let us pass, though, since he's Master Durzel's granddaughter." "That's risky," Stella says. "He may become suspicious." "I think so too," Joanna says. "As I told you, I can't let ordinary citizens enter." Alright, we need to meet... We need to talk to her. So she can play hide-and-seek with the soldier, and he'll get distracted or walk away from his post, and then we can get to the tower. But that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.